Jury deliberations resume tomorrow in Jodi Arias' sentencing retrial. She was convicted in 2013 in the death of her ex-boyfriend, Travis Alexander, but the jury couldn't agree on life or death. So a new jury in Arizona will determine her fate. HLN legal analyst Joey Jackson is here with more. Joey, it was good to see you. So let's talk about the three possible outcomes for sentencing. We got life, death, or life with the possibility of release eligibility after 25 years. We like to read the tea leaves. What are you thinking the jury will decide?
Aha, good morning, Lynn. Well, listen, since I'm an incredibly inaccurate predictor, admittedly, I will hedge my bets. I know, some expert I am. I will hedge my bets. Now, here's the way it goes. Of course, we know that in Arizona, they have not executed a woman since 1930. That being said, it's unlikely, if you look at Arizona's history, with two women being on death row presently, that they will indeed execute her, that is, find her eligible for the death penalty, which of course she is, and then give it to her. However, I certainly wouldn't be surprised, Lynn, based on the heinous nature of this act, that they do. Remember, at the end of the day, it's about the victim. And who is that victim? It's Travis Alexander. We've heard the gut-wrenching impact statements from his family and how his loss, you see him there, has so drastically altered their lives. And that's what the jury's considering. And that's a major aggravating factor, not to mention how she brutalized him. She slit his throat. She shot him in the head. She stabbed him upwards of 30 times. So I would not be surprised, Lynn, if they gave her the death penalty, although certainly it appears that it may not be likely that they do so.
Interesting. Let's talk about the jury. You know, I understand the jurors were seen carrying in a cake tray and a crock pot. I mean, some sort of potluck party. Are they really permitted to do something like that during deliberations?
Sure. You know, what happens, Lynn, is remember, jurors do get close, and while you're not allowed throughout the course of the case to be speaking about it or to be expressing your views with other jurors concerning what your wishes are, you do forge relationships. You talk about things, the Academy Awards, sporting events, the Super Bowl, various things, and certainly things you have in common. So it's not uncommon for jurors to get close, even though you're not discussing the specifics of what you want to happen with Jodi Arias. And so what this appears to mean, if they're bringing in crock pots and the like, is that they're taking their obligations seriously. They're going into that room, they're exchanging opinions, and they're trying to forge consensus. And as we know, that could take time. And as we also know, Lynn, all 12 people, all 12 of those jurors have to be unanimous if indeed what they say is actually going to be a verdict. Remember, the last jury was hung. That is, they couldn't all agree. The goal of this jury is for unanimous consent to be reached, whatever option they choose.
So that we're not back here yet again. Meantime, Joey Jackson, thanks so much as always. And I know you've been covering this, and you will be this week on The Daily Share starting at 3 p.m. Eastern Time. Thanks so much for being
with us.
Indeed.
A pleasure, Lynn. Have a great day.
You too.